It was here.
Oh no.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh lord.
Somebody just bust the Prime Minister head with a stone. Somebody just hit the Prime Minister in his head with a stone. I don't know if he's dead, guys.
One viewers and subscribers, welcome back to my channel. If you haven't subscribed already, please hit the subscribe button, people. So yo, news coming out of Saint Vincent and the Grenadines, people. Their Prime Minister Ralph Gonzalez was attacked while heading to Parliament, and I'm getting this article from Loop News, people. And it goes on to say, Prime Minister of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, Dr. Ralph Gonzalez, is receiving medical treatment after he was injured while returning to a Parliament sitting this evening, where fiery protests are happening in the capital of Kingston. Loop News Caribbean spoke with the Prime Minister's press secretary, Sihan Marshall, who confirmed the incident. He said, from what he has gathered, it would appear that a protester threw some object and that object struck the Prime Minister and caused him to be injured. Gonzalez was taken to the Milton Gato Memorial Hospital. Agricultural Minister Saboto Caesar, who returned to the Parliament sitting, showed blood splatters on his shirt, which he said belonged to Comrade Ralph. People are protesting in front of the Parliament against proposed amendments to the Public Health Act. And people, this is a developing story at the moment, people. Once I get more information on it, I will give you guys an update, people. But in the video, they're saying the Prime Minister was hit with a rock. Yes, you heard that correctly. People them angry, people are upset, the people them just take things into them own hand. People, as I said, it's a developing story. Once I get more information, I will pass it along. I'll let you know what one. Alright, people, bless up in yourself. Much love and appreciation for Yard and Abroad TV. Much love, people. Bless up.
come out to bring the crowd under control.
Some of the protesters in Fort Carlet, like, Gonzalo was injured and was taken to the Milton Keynes Memorial Hospital, where we were told he is still in hospital.